Welcome you all for Fluid Power System Module 1, Introduction to Fluid Power System, Lecture 4. Seals are sealing devices. One of the most common problems associated with any fluid system, either hydraulic or pneumatic, is leakage. Because of this leakage, it leads to several problems like loss of power, loss of fluid, temperature rise, increased power usage, reduction in efficiency, environmental damage, and safety hazards. Hence, sealing devices are used in a fluid power system to solve above problems. Leakage can be overcome to some extent by proper maintenance of the system and proper selection of seals and sealing during the design stage. Leakage can be avoided for some extent by a proper maintenance for time to time and proper selection of sealing materials in the beginning of the design stage. This means that seals and sealing play an important role in preventing the leakage. Functions of seals. Seals are used in fluid power systems to prevent excessive internal and external leakage and to keep out contamination. Various functions of seals include the following. First one, to prevent the leakage, both internal and external leakages. Second, to prevent the dust and other particles entering into the system. It means keep out the contaminations from the hydraulic system. To maintain the pressure, operating pressure. To enhance the service life and reliability of the hydraulic system. These four functions are plays very important role to avoid a leakage. Classification of hydraulic seals. Hydraulic seals are broadly classified based on several factors. They are, first one, based on method of sealing. Second, based on relative motion exists between the seal and other parts. Third, based on geometric shape. And last, based on seal material. First classification, method of sealing. According to method of sealing, there are two types: positive sealing and non-positive sealing. In case of positive sealing, these sealing elements do not allow any leakage, either it is internal or external. In case of non-positive sealing, these sealing elements do not allow, it allows a small amount of internal leakages. Example, clearance of the piston and cylinder to provide a movement of lubrication film between them. Second classification, relative motion between seal and other parts. Here also two types: static seal and dynamic seal. Static seals are compressed between two rigidly connected parts. Static seals are used between mating parts that do not move relative to each other. Okay. And second, dynamic seal. These are assembled between a mating parts that move about each other. Means it is installed between the parts which are move relative to one another. Third classification, according to a geometric shape. Here a various geometric shapes are utilized: O ring seal, V ring seal, U ring or U cup seal, T ring seal, piston rings, piston cup packings, etc. You can see by diagram also. Here you can see O-ring seal. See, the shape of the ring is a alphabet of letter O, a O-ring seal. Next is V-ring seal. See, you can see here the alphabet letter V, V-ring seal. U-ring and U-cup seal. See, U-ring and here cup like structure, U cup. Here T ring seal, piston rings, piston cup packing. It is inserted in the piston. This is piston cup packings. Fourth classification, based on sealing material. Seals are manufactured from variety of natural and synthetic rubbers. The choice of sealing material mainly depends on two factors. One is what type of fuel or fluid used, and second is operating temperature range. See here, a variety of natural and synthetic rubbers are utilized. Natural rubbers are rarely used and synthetic rubbers are commonly used. Most commonly used seal materials are leather, buna N, silicone, neoprene, tetrafluoroethylene, and VITA. These six materials are commonly used as a seals. First one, leather. See, it is less expensive and its operating temperature range is minus 50 degree centigrade to 90 degree centigrade. What it means? See, the leather tends to squeal when dry and cannot operate above 90 degree centigrade. And leather does not operate well at cold temperatures to about minus 50 degree centigrade. Buna N, it is also less expensive material. It maintains good sealing characteristics. Its operating temperature range is minus 45 degree centigrade to 110 degree centigrade, during which it maintains a good sealing characteristics. Next is silicone. It is an elastomer. Its operating temperature range is minus 65 degree centigrade to 235 degree centigrade. Compared to previous two cases, it is extremely wide temperature range. It is widely used for rotating shaft seals and static seals, where a wide range of operating temperature is expected, and it is not used for reciprocating seal applications because it has a low tear resistance. Next seal material is neoprene. Its operating temperature range is 50 degree centigrade to 120 degree centigrade, and it is not suitable for temperature above 120 degree centigrade because it has a tendency to vulcanize. Next sealing material is tetrafluoroethylene. This is most widely used plastic for seals of hydraulic system. It is tough in nature, chemically inert material. It is waxy solid and it has a low coefficient of friction, and it has excellent resistance to chemical breakdown up to temperature of 370 degree centigrade. This is the very good material for elevated temperatures. And last one, Viton. Its operating temperature range is 28 degree centigrade to 240 degree centigrade. It is a elastomer type of seal. It is most widely used at elevated temperatures up to 240 degree centigrade. These seals are more rigid and are often used as wiper or scraper seals on cylinders. Next concept is pipes and hoses. These are also called as conductors. In a hydraulic system, the fluid flows through a distribution system. It consisting of pipes, nothing but a conductors and fittings, which carry the fluid from the reservoir through operating components and back to the reservoir. Hydraulic systems use primarily four types of conductors. They are steel pipes, steel tubing, plastic tubing, flexible hoses. Steel pipes are extensively used in fluid power systems. They are rapidly supplemented by steel or plastic tubing. The major disadvantages of steel pipes are their weight and the large number of fitting requirements for connection, and its greatest advantage is its mechanical strength. And second, steel tubing, it is most widely used material for hydraulic system conductors. One major reason of its popularity is the fact that it can be easily formed to fit irregular paths so that fewer fittings are required. Third one, plastic tubing. It is available in polyethylene, polypropylene, polyvinyl chloride and nylon. Each material has specific characteristics that make it more suitable for some services than for the others. In general, plastic tubing is most often used in pneumatic systems. Next is flexible hoses. There are places on many machines where rigid pipe or tubing cannot be used because of their inflexibility. In such cases, these flexible hoses are used. The choice of the conductor is mainly depends on system's operating pressure ranges and flow rates of fluid. Next concept is quick acting couplings. One additional type of fitting is quick acting coupling. It is used for both tubes and hoses. It is used mainly where a conductor must be disconnected frequently from a component. Wherever the pipes are disconnected frequently, in such cases, these quick acting couplings are utilized. This type of fitting permits assembly and disassembly in a matter of seconds. In quick acting couplings, three basic designs: straight through, one way shut off, two way shut off. In first design, like straight through, this design offers minimum restriction to flow but does not prevent fluid loss from the system when the coupling is disconnected. Second type of design, one way shut off. This design locates the shut off at the fluid source connection but leaves the actuator component unblocked. Leakage from the system is not excessive in short runs, but system contamination due to the entrance of dirt in the end of the fitting can be a problem, especially with mobile equipment located at the work site. And third design, two-way shutoff. This design provides positive shutoff at both ends of pressurized lines when disconnected. Pressure drop in hoses or pipes. Pressure drop occurs due to frictional forces acting on a fluid as it flows through the tube or pipe. High flow velocities or high fluid viscosities result in a larger pressure drop across a section of pipe or a wall. Low viscosity will result in lower or no pressure drop. The pressure losses in hose or pipe contribute to the overall efficiency of a fluid power system. See, because of pressure drop in pipes or hoses will lead to several problems, so it will reduce the overall efficiency. So to reduce pressure drop, several considerations to be taken. They are: reduce interior surface roughness of the pipes, increase pipe diameter, minimize length of the piping system, minimize the number of elbows, T's, fittings and valves, etc. Replace 90 degree turns with gentle bends. So when you follow these considerations, you can reduce pressure drop for some extent. The losses can be estimated using the Darcy-Weisbach equation, delta P equal to FD L by D rho V square by 2, where delta P is pressure loss in Newton per meter square, FD Darcy friction factor, L pipe length in meter, D hydraulic diameter in meter, V fluid flow average velocity in meter per second, rho fluid density in kg per meter cube.